Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. So in this lecture we have studied about class AB amplifier, or you can say push pull amplifier, right? And I told you it is the most important topic of this chapter. So today we are going to learn about complementary symmetry amplifier, and in this topic we are not going in detail because it is out of the syllabus, right? So we just draw the figure, we just know how it works, and we will see advantages and disadvantages, that's all, right? So this is the figure of complementary symmetry amplifier. First you should learn what is the complementary, right? So complementary means, before explaining this, I want to ask you one question. There are two types of the transistors. What are those two types? आप कुछ समझाओ तो पहला हम तो एक क्वेश्चन पूछो जो कि बेटाइप का ट्रांजिस्टर होए जाए ये बेटाइप क्या है, right? पहला टाइप सोच है तो क्या NPN फर्स्ट टाइप इज NPN ट्रांजिस्टर, सेकेंड टाइप इज PNP ट्रांजिस्टर, right? So these two are the types of the transistor, and whenever you use both of these transistor in the same circuit, at that time you can say this is the complementary transistor pair, right? So in this topic, or in this complementary symmetry amplifier, we are going to use two transistors and both are complementary to each other, right? So this one is the first transistor T1, it is NPN type transistor. This is the second type transistor T2, and its type is PNP. Both are connected, so it is called complementary. Now the meaning of the second word, symmetry. What is the symmetry? Okay, if here there are two testers, or suppose here there are two hands, both are symmetrical. Why? There are five fingers, I mean four finger one thumb. Here there are four finger one thumb, but these both are complementary. Why? Thumb is here, fingers like this. Thumb here, finger like this. So it is the complementary, but parameters are same. Both fingers are same, both thumbs are same, everything is same. So you can say when parameters are similar, at that time those two transistors are symmetrical transistor, right? જ્યારે જ્યારે પેરામીટર ટ્રાન્ઝિસ્ટરના સરખા હશે ત્યારે ત્યારે એ સિમેટ્રિકલ એમ્પ્લીફાયર છે, એવું સોરી સિમેટ્રિકલ ટ્રાન્ઝિસ્ટર છે એવું કહી શકે. સો હિયર કોમ્પ્લિમેન્ટરી ટ્રાન્ઝિસ્ટર ઇઝ કનેક્ટેડ, સો વી ડોન્ટ નીડ એની સેન્ટર ટાઈપ ટ્રાન્સફોર્મર. હિયર વી હેવ યુઝ ધ ટ્રાન્સફોર્મર, બટ ઇટ ઇઝ નોટ સેન્ટર ટાઈપ ટ્રાન્સફોર્મર, it is simple transformer, right? How it operates? Whenever you give positive half input, this transistor T1 becomes forward biased and this one becomes reverse biased, right? Now in negative half, T2 becomes forward biased and T1 becomes reverse biased. So in the positive half T1 works, in the negative half you can say T2 works, and like that you can amplify the signal. NPN transistor. This NPN transistor helps you to amplify upper half of the input. This T2 transistor helps you to amplify the lower half of input. Same like I told you in Pushpul.
नीचे नू नीचे ना सिग्नल एम्पलीफाई करे ऊपर नू ऊपर ना सिग्नल एम्पलीफाई करे दैट्स ऑल एडवांटेजेस
इट हैज हाई एफिशिएंसी बिकॉज हियर वी आर यूजिंग जनरली इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द वर्किंग ऑफ क्लास बी दैट्स द रीजन एफिशिएंसी इज क्वाइट हाई सेकंड वन नो ट्रांसफॉर्मर सो its cost and weight is less. Disadvantage is hard to find similar characteristic pair. Yes, I told you. Whenever you are using this complementary symmetry, you need same parameter transistors. If it is not there, then I told you in push-pull, you will get uneven amplification. And here, the same thing you will get. That's the reason. Yes, that's the reason it is hard to find similar characteristic pair. Right? Circuit needs external power supply, or you can say another separate power supply to this circuit. So you need two power supplies. So it is a little bit costly. Right? So now we are going to check the difference, or you can say comparison of different types of amplifier. Let's check it out. So here it is the comparison between different types of power amplifier. So here these are the parameters on which basis we have to compare that those power amplifiers, right? These are the parameters on which we have comparing the power amplifiers. Class A, class B, class C and class AB, you can call it push-pull amplifier 2. You can call it push-pull amplifier 2. Right? So, first parameter which we are going to compare for different types of power amplifier is collector current IC. When we have started this chapter, I told you, when the collector current flowing the full cycle, that is class A amplifier. So here collector current is flowing in the full cycle, so it is the class A type amplifier. When only positive half current is flowing, then it is class B, and less than the positive half current is flowing, then it is class C. But in class AB, I told you class AB is the combination of class B type amplifier, and that's why current is flowing full cycle, but in the negative half some portion is chopped, or you can say some portion is cut off. That's the reason it is not completely 360, but some less than the 360, but greater than 180 degree. Greater than 180 degree, but less than 360 degree. Here it is 180, but it is less than 180. It is 180 and it is full 360 degree. Now, second part or second parameter is conduction angle of collector current. Here, collector current is flowing for the full cycle. So, it is for 360 degree, or you can say full cycle. Here collector current is flowing for the half cycle, and one half cycle is for 180 degree. Here I already told you it is less than 180, and here it is greater than 180 but less than 360. Third point is point Q, or you can say position of point Q on load line. For class A, it is at the center. For class B, it is on the x-axis. For the class C, it is below the x-axis. That is the reason we get this much portion at the output only, right? And for class A, being above x-axis but below the midpoint. Next parameter is distortion in output.
these three parameters are most important for the one mark question, right? So you have to remember all these three parameters, and even this question is most likely this can be asked like compare different types of power amplifier with their parameters. So you have to compare and you have to write all these things. Distortion in output voltage is in class A you get full cycle output, so there is no distortion. Class B you get only half, so you can say this sorry, you can say distortion is more than class A. In class C you get only some portion of these half cycles, so you can say more than A, B and AB. So distortion is much more higher in class C type amplifier, and in class AB this portion is cut off. It is very small portion, right? It is less than this, it is less than this, but more than this. So you can say that yes, it is moderate, it is low. Efficiency is lowest 25% to 50% higher, or 78.5%. Highest efficiency in class C it is 95%, and class AB is made of class B, that's the reason you get 50 and 78.5 in between. Power dissipation in transistor very high, low, very low and moderate. So you have to remember all these classic comparison of these power amplifiers, because it is the most important topic, and previous one is also, I mean in previous lecture whatever we have studied, a class AB or you can say push-pull amplifier, that is also very important topic. So here we are going to complete this chapter, and in next lecture we are going to start a new chapter. So till then, thank you so much.